In developing countries around the world, climate change threatens to jeopardize economic and social development objectives and human well-being. In Zambia, temperatures are rising and droughts and flooding are becoming more frequent, placing rural livelihoods at risk, from subsistence farmers to agribusiness workers. In the Dominican Republic, urban water infrastructure is at risk from climate stressors like hurricanes and inland flooding, putting the health of hundreds of thousands at risk. The U.S. Agency for International Development, or USAID, is addressing these and other climate risks in its planning and programming. In Zambia, the Country Development Cooperation Strategy, or CDCS, seeks to improve the poorest people's resilience to a changing climate. In the Dominican Republic, a USAID-supported activity led to the relocation of new pumping stations for a wastewater treatment plant to safer locations. These are two examples of climate risk management, a process to assess and address climate risks throughout USAID's planning and programming. Climate risk management became mandatory for all new USAID strategies on October 2015 and for all new projects and activities on October 2016, reflecting the agency's desire to improve the impact and sustainability of its investments. The process is iterative. At each stage in planning and programming, climate risk management builds on work done during previous stages. Let's see what this could look like. At the strategy level, a mission uses USAID's climate risk screening and management tool to rate programming sectors as high, moderate, or low climate risk, and then integrates the results into the CDCS. They also note opportunities to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Nothing more is required for sectors rated as low climate risk, whereas further analyses and additional actions may be needed for programming in sectors with moderate and high climate risk. At the project level, when an agriculture officer sees that her sector was rated high risk in the CDCS, the project design team decides to conduct a more detailed climate risk analysis and then addresses the risk of increased drought by using drought-resilient varieties and including crop diversification. At the activity level, a design team working to reduce malaria incidence reviews the climate risks identified at the project level and decides to expand the activity area to include communities living at higher elevations where mosquito habitats are predicted to move. By considering climate risks and opportunities throughout planning and programming, USAID can increase the effectiveness and sustainability of its investments. It takes teamwork, and USAID's partners are a critical part of this effort. Through climate risk management, together we can safeguard our development programming and continue improving people's lives.